Hi everyone, this is Kubra Khan. Subscribe to Something Hot and hit the bell icon to get the latest news because you would not want to miss it.
My name is Hasan Chaudhary. You're tuned into Something Hot, and बहुत कम ऐसा होता है कि हमें टेलीविजन के ऊपर कुछ थॉट प्रोवोकिंग या सोल स्टरिंग किस्म के ड्रामे देखने को मिले. फॉर्चुनेटली आजकल एक ऐसा ड्रामा टेलीविजन पे आ रहा है जो आप लोग भी बड़े शौक से देख रहे हैं, हम भी बड़े मजे के साथ तो उसको फॉलो कर रहे हैं और बड़े क्लोजली फॉलो कर रहे हैं. ऑफकोर्स आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट अलिफ. इसी सिलसिले में एक एक्ट्रेस हैं जिनको बड़े अरसे से मैं एंक्शियसली वेट कर रहा था कि उनका इंटरव्यू करूँ, एंड आई एम विद हर टुडे. It's my great pleasure to have Kubra Khan with me, so let's welcome her and have a conversation with her about her character Husn-e Jahan. Assalamu alaikum Kubra.
Wa alaikum assalam. How are you? Kaise
I'm aap? Good. Aap kaisi hain?
Alhamdulillah, bilkul theek.
Itna aapka popular drama Alif.
Ji.
Aur itna before I begin and start asking you all these questions, maine sirf ye kehna tha ki aapki jo performance as Husn-e Jahan, I think it's astonishing.
Thank you.
इतनी जबरदस्त आपने एक्टिंग की है और मुझे पर्सनली ऐसा लगता है कि I don't think any other actress could have done justice to the character the way you have.
Really?
Of course. I mean, your scenes with Pehlaj, the young woman.
Yeah.
They're so like, you know, it's I've almost cried. I say I've almost because you know they've थोड़ा सा वो कम ड्यूरेशन होता है उनका. ड्यूरेशन अभी तक लंबा नहीं
हुआ. That is true.
But आपका आपको कैसा फीडबैक मिल रहा है, आपको कैसा लग रहा है?
बहुत प्यारा फीडबैक मिल रहा है, एंड ऑब्वियसली सीन्स कम है मेरे, एंड देयर आर फ्लैशबैक्स हैं मोस्टली टू बी ऑनेस्ट, लेकिन जितने आए हैं माशाल्लाह बहुत अच्छी फीडबैक है. लेकिन ओवरऑल ड्रामे की जो फीडबैक है, आई लव दैट. आई लव कि लोग रिलेट कर रहे हैं ड्रामे से, आई लव कि लोग सीख रहे हैं उससे, कि ऑब्वियसली ये है जर्नी ही है सारे लोगों की जो जो ड्रामे के अंदर हैं, जितने कैरेक्टर्स हैं उन सबकी जर्नी है टू गो टू अलमी एंड फाइंड द राइट पाथ. And I think that people are liking it, and that's the main thing. कि एक वो जो message था वो delivered हो रहा है, and that's all that matters.
तो ये बताएं कि जब आपके पास आया ये script, what compelled you to take on Husn-e Jahan?
Funny, क्योंकि initially when I was told कि मैं माँ बनूँगी हमजा की, I was like, okay.
मैं लगती तो कहीं से नहीं हूँ हमजा की.
I mean like I get it, I do get it. I could be very motherly, don't get me wrong. लेकिन I was a little confused. लेकिन then obviously मुझे सना ने explain किया कि actually वो different time है and everything. And I read the character and I fell in love. Literally जिस तरह वो लिखा हुआ है, the way उसकी journey जो है, something just pulled me. And obviously drama शुरू होने से पहले कुछ चीजें हुई भी थी where people were like she's not doing it, Kubra नहीं कर रही है अब कर रही है, अब नहीं कर रही. So all this stuff was happening. लेकिन I think लिखा था. I think this was supposed to be my character because it changed so much in my life.
तो उसने जहाँ प्ले करने के लिए कोई तैयारी आपने की खास तरह की? सबसे पहले तो ये बताएं आपने नॉवल पढ़ा या नहीं?
एक्चुअली मैंने नॉवल नहीं पढ़ा हुआ.
अच्छा?
नहीं पढ़ा हुआ, क्योंकि जब मैंने स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ी थी तो आई थॉट उस टाइम मैं नॉवल पढ़ लूँ, लेकिन दो रीजन से. एक था कि मुझे उर्दू नहीं पढ़नी आती. दूसरा आई फील कि मे बी आई शुड हैव माई ओन एडेप्टेशन ऑफ इट एज वेल, क्योंकि जब आप किसी चीज़ में बहुत ज़्यादा निटिग्रिटी ढूंढते हो ना, तो फिर वो मुश्किल हो जाता है टू एक्चुअली एडजस्ट एंड अडेप्ट एवरीथिंग दैट यू वॉन्ट फ्रॉम द कैरेक्टर. तो इसलिए आई थॉट कि नहीं, लेट मी जस्ट गो विद द कैरेक्टर एंड लेट हसीब भाई डू हिज मैजिक.
बट अपेरेंटली ये ऑडियो पे भी अवेलेबल है, सो वंस यू डन विद द ड्रामा यू कैन हियर इट.
आई विल, बट आई थिंक आई एम गोना हियर इट इन अ लॉन्ग व्हाइल. आई वॉन्ट टू लेट दिस सिंक इन फर्स्ट.
अच्छा, मुझे ये बताएं कि मैंने भी आपकी तरह नॉवल नहीं पढ़ा हुआ, तो आई एम फाइंडिंग मोर एंड मोर डिटेल्स अबाउट Husn-e Jahan एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स एज एंड व्हेन आई एम वाचिंग द एपिसोड्स. तो मुझे ये बताएं कि जो Husn-e Jahan है, इन हर हार्ट इज शी जस्ट अ वेरी सिंपल गर्ल हु फेल इन लव, और इज इट अ मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कैरेक्टर देन व्हाट मीट्स द आई?
Actually, that's the funny thing. कि in her heart, she was always a simple girl. She was always a simple girl. लेकिन उसको, I think जिस तरह उसकी upbringing हुई थी, जिस तरह से उसका उसके आसपास हर चीज़ दिखाई गई थी कि this is how you should see life. She was seeing life through her mother's eyes. उसको जो दिखाया गया उसने वो देखा. And then जब अल्लाह ने उसे दिखाया, that's when her eyes actually opened and she's like, this is all it is. But also, She is a little complicated in a way that uski simplicity hai because she fell in love with Taha, but it's why she fell in love with Taha. You know, it's because she never found that connection in her work or there was anything that she was doing. Usko wo connection nahi mila. Aur wo Taha ke through usko mila, but that connection was with Allah. Jab wo pehli dafa usko dekhti hai, she doesn't fall in love with all ladka dance kar raha hai. It was actually the ruhaniyat uske chehre pe jo thi aur jis passion ke saath aur jis tarah aur spirituality ke saath wo upar dekh ke bas he's having a conversation with Allah. That's what she fell in love with. Ki, what is this? How is this? Like, why have I not seen this before? That's, I think, what she fell in love with, and that's what she wanted to find
so
as well.
In a lot of ways, jo journey momin ki hai, jo hum dekh rahe hain abhi tak, usne jahan went through the same journey.
Basically, yeah. And I'm sad ki momin turned out to be the way he did, but he'll find his way, I guess.
Huh. And so, you know, what all you've just said about your interaction with Taha, and of course, ye to hume scenes dekhne ko milenge.
Ji, 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 ji.
But jo husne jahan ki journey hai, wo bhi hume dekhne ko milegi detail mein?
Itni detail nahi hogi, lekin enough that you understand Momin's behavior. Ki Momin aisa kyun hai jaisa wo dikha rahe hai.
Abhi?
Haan ji. Yeah, yeah, of course, abhi.
Kyunki baad mein uski transition bhi honi hai.
Exactly, exactly. Sorry.
Yes.
So, why is he like this? Or obviously, the thing is, he's just hurt. You know, he feels betrayed. That's what it is at the end of the day. Lekin jab usse pata chalega ki actually, har ko inki do sides hoti hain. And of course, usne ek cheez dekhi, usko dikhai gayi, usne believe ki. Lekin uski ek aur side bhi thi. Uski maa itni buri nahi thi jitna usko bataya, jitna usko yaad hai, or whatever, like something like that. But you will get to see a lot more of Husne Jahan. Maybe not as much as people would like to, but enough that I think they will still love her.
Achha, ek cheez jo personally I've not been able to decipher as yet is Husne Jahan was an actress, right?
Yeah.
But she was also a dancer.
So she was a performer.
Sorry, the dada says na ki wo rakasa thi. So kya scene hai wo?
So basically she's a performer, right? She's a film artist but also a performer. I think back in the days they had that where, you know, actors weren't just actors, they were also performers as well. But that didn't mean she was kind of just a dancer. Well, I think jati thi internationally traveled karti thi. Like they have, I don't know if they've shown it or not yet, but internationally traveled karti thi. And she would actually perform to show the art form of her country at that point. Lekin later on, jo scenes dikhaye gaye hain, usme I can understand why people would misunderstand it. Kyunki obviously kafi saare mard uske saamne khade hain and she's dancing in the middle. But that's because of her mother. Because her mother wants her to get work again. So she's like, just this is the only way you can do it now.
मेरे लिए एक point of confusion जो था वो यही था कि जब वो टर्की से वापस आई है तो मुझे ऐसा लगा कि oh she was a big star and like you know film actress. तो ये क्या बहुत सारे मर्द इकट्ठे हुए हैं और वो dance कर रही है तो वो ये क्या उसका change of jobs भी हुआ है आने के बाद?
नहीं change of jobs नहीं हुआ. Actually the thing is कि when she came back वो completely different बंदी थी. वो एक अल्लाह की बंदी बन गई थी लेकिन उसकी माँ वॉन्टेड हर टू कंटिन्यू वर्किंग एट दैट पॉइंट बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली शी हैड टू फीड पहलाज एज वेल तो उसकी माँ कहती थी कि तुम अब बूढ़ी होगी कुछ नहीं है तुम्हारे पास ये वो तो तुम्हें टू अट्रैक्ट द प्रोड्यूसर्स वो इट वॉज लाइक अ कमर्शियल लाइक अ एड कि यू नो दिस इज व्हाट यू बीन मिसिंग आउट ऑन खान जस्ट टू सेल मी बेसिकली कि उसने जहाँ भी वही है जो पहले थी नॉट के शी हैड अ चेंज ऑफ जॉब बट इट वॉज मोर लाइक जस्ट टू लेट देम नो कि शी इज एग्जैक्टली हाउ शी वॉज बिफोर कि डांस भी वैसे करती है, she's still the best at what she does and stuff. But it wasn't anything to do with, you know, the things that people are thinking.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So tell me about the experience of shooting. Like, you know, you guys have shot mostly in Turkey. आपके जो sequences हैं, कुछ आपके sequences अभी तक हमने देखे हैं कि वो पाकिस्तान में, but ज़्यादातर आपका काम Turkey में था.
Turkey में भी काफी काम था और we were shooting here in Nathiagarhi as well actually. And the experience was amazing actually. जिस तरह मेरी bonding हुई पहलाज के साथ और दादाजी के साथ as well, it was just brilliant to actually have that shown on screen. और लेकिन सर्दी बहुत थी. I mean literally I kid you not, कुछ ऐसे scenes हैं जो I think teasers में भी आए हुए हैं where I don't know how I acted क्योंकि actually बर्फ पड़ रही थी. And I am like मैं एक लेयर फैन की बैठी हुई वहाँ पे लाइक ताहा पर इट वाज रियली हार्ड सर्दी बहुत ज़्यादा थी लेकिन लकीली हमारी टीम बहुत अच्छी थी एंड हसीब भाई डज मैजिक और उन्होंने बहुत ही अच्छी तरह से हमें हम सब को हैंडल किया, सो इट वर्क्ड आउट फॉर द बेस्ट.
सो हुसैन जहाँ की जिंदगी में एक और बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट कैरेक्टर है जो कि उसका मेकअप आर्टिस्ट सुल्तान. So, हमें
funny you speak about that.
Why?
nobody spoken about that yet.
Because it's very intriguing कि उसका जवान बच्चा मर गया है और उसकी बीवी बेटी उसके पास आती है, you know, looking for solace के यार कि मेरा बाप मुझे गले लगाएगा और बोलेगा कि अच्छा कोई बात नहीं तुम्हारा भाई मर गया है या प्यार करेगा. And he says हुसैन जहां भी तो मर गई थी. So that's kind of a big deal, यार. You lose your only son, yet you're thinking about this actress that you used to work for. So it obviously there's a lot more there than what meets the eye.
Yeah. Well, obviously you'll get to find out a lot more when you watch the drama. But Husn-e Jahan wasn't. Was sirf Husn-e Jahan nahi thi Sultan ke liye. It was much more than that. She was the person, not even just a woman. She was the person for him. To wo usko usne Sultan ne Husn-e Jahan ko itna rutba diya hua tha ki when she died, it everything kind of ended for him. So at that point, it just became numb. And also, I think aage obviously unravel karenge story properly. Lekin he was never actually in love with his wife either. You know what I mean? So I think that's one of the other reasons as well. Ki usne apne aap ko numb kar liya tha. And I understand ki obviously it's his only son. And obviously it should have affected him more. Mujhe bhi is cheez ka kaafi hua tha ki... Okay, but I think he puts Husn-e Jahan above everything, which is obviously probably not right, but that's what he was.
But that's understandable. But ye batayein ki Sultan ki zindagi mein to Husn-e Jahan ek bahut bada maqam rakhti hai. Husn-e Jahan ki zindagi mein Sultan ka kya maqam hai?
Sultan was very dear. Husn-e Jahan ke bahut kareeb tha wo, and she adored him to bits as well. Lekin I think baaki cheeze abhi unravel hongi. I feel like I don't want to say too much.
But ye is relationship ke upar bhi clarity hame milegi is what I'm trying to ask. Main details nahi poochha.
Yeah.
But ye kat ye gutthi suljhegi ya
nahi? Oh yeah, definitely suljhegi. Bahut clear ho jayega. It'll show ke Husn-e Jahan ka, you know, kya rutba tha Sultan ki zindagi mein aur Sultan kya maane rakhta tha Husn-e Jahan ki zindagi mein. Everything will be very clear. But slowly everything's going to open up.
You know, as viewers,
and
I can only speak of myself, and I'm sure jo dekh rahe hain shayad wo behtar bata sake. You know, Alif does have a lot of impact on you.
Yes.
In the sense that, you know, I was just telling you off camera ke yaar bade lengthy scenes hote hain jisme characters aapas mein baatein kar rahe hain. Typically you'll get bored. Ki yaar kya ek budda aadmi ek jawan se baat kar raha hai ya ek maa apne bacche se baatein kar rahi hai.
Exactly.
But agar aap usko drama ko gaur se dekh rahe hain aur shauk se dekh rahe hain तो वो चीजें आपको बड़ी मजे की लगती हैं।
That is true, yeah.
तो व्यूअर पे जब इतना स्ट्रॉन्ग इम्पैक्ट है, आप जब प्ले कर रही थी उसने जहां आपको क्या फील हुआ, आपके ऊपर कैसा इन्फ्लुएंस है अलिफ
का? मैं बाकी किसी कैरेक्टर की तो बात नहीं कर सकती, to be really honest. लेकिन जो इम्पैक्ट उसने जहां ने मुझ पर छोड़ा है, आई थिंक इट्स अ लाइफ लॉन्ग इम्पैक्ट. क्योंकि आई नो इट्स गोना साउंड लाइक अ ब्रोकन रिकॉर्ड, you know, people keep hearing the same thing again and again. Lekin jitna maine usse seekha hai aur jitna maine usne jahan se relate kiya hai, it's unreal. Kyunki the way she understood life, the way she tried to find love, and she tried to find the love of Allah through a person, and then realized that actually, you know what, it's never through a person, it's always directly. I can really relate to that, and I just think that not just Husn-e Jahan, Momin's character, Dada's character, Pehlaj's, obviously, even the younger Momin's character. I think there's just so much to learn. And the way Umaira M has written this, I don't know how she does it. In all honesty, she's a magician. I don't know how she does it.
No, of course. I mean, she is. Everybody who's watching Alif and who's read Alif would obviously agree
exactly
with you.
Like, I used to actually read my lines, and I used to be like, how? Either cry or just sit there, like, think for hours and hours. You're like, that is true. So true. Like, that's what life is about, you know? So, I mean, I think the entire script has had a great impact on me, and I think a lot of other people as well.
No, of course, we know that Hamza's gone on a different journey or has decided to embark on a different journey. And you almost gave us a scare in your recent interview with Haroon. Shout out to Haroon, great guy.
Hey, love Haroon.
You said that you might quit. or you were thinking of quitting or something along those lines, or mujhe ek second ko laga ke hai ye kya scene hai.
Okay, let me clarify this. Okay, so there was a point last year, there was two things I said about quitting. One thing was that there was a point last year that I thought I could have let go of everything altogether, but this was before Alif, maybe middle of Alif actually, and then obviously I continued, but actually Alif played a part in my decision that I've chosen to be on this journey, and the journey doesn't mean ki main, you know, Sufi ho gayi hun ya main hijab kar lungi or anything. The journey is more about making myself a better person than I was yesterday. That's what the journey is about. And I have just decided ki I don't want to do things that jo Allah ko khafa kare, to that extent ki main wapas na aa sakun. Main itna deep kisi cheez mein nahi jana chahti ki wapas aane ka rasta hi bhul jaun main. That's my main thing. So what I actually said was, I love my art. Like, mujhe acting karna, I love it to bits because I learn so much. I mean, Alif is the biggest example of that. But if at any point in my life I feel ki I am deviating from my connection, then yes, I might quit completely. But as of now, no, I'm not quitting. I love what I do. So just to clarify, people, I'm not quitting. But yes, I'm trying to find my balance, and I will try to find my balance as much as I can through my work, because I have realized that you can't do that. You don't have to always do things that, you know, are in demand or are the norm of the industry. You can move away from the norm as well, and apne tareeke se bhi chal sakte ho. And that's what I learned from Alif as well. See how much impact it's had on me.
So would you say that you'd be rethinking your decisions of signing projects, taking on projects of the sorts that you've done in the past?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, definitely. That's exactly what it is. Because now I want to focus on working. Pehle bhi, I've tried my best to do things jo somewhat enlightened kare ya impact kare ya teach kare in some way or form hamare awam ko. Lekin, obviously, I have failed several times as well. You know, I've let myself down several times as well. Lekin, I think kafi time ho gaya hai ki main bahut dekh ke project kar rahi hu. Since, I think, after Alif, I've decided ke, you know, I have to really...
Oh ho, agar JPNA 3 banne wali hai, toh agar aapko offer hoti hai, toh aap karengi ya nahi?
You just put me on a spot. In all honesty, I can never say no to Nadeem bhai. Lekin another thing, uske andar kuch waisa hoga. Main ye nahi keh rahi hu, main sirf Allah Allah wale drama hi karungi. Lekin bas kuch cheeze hain jo mujhe... The thing is, even humare art ke andar, it's not everything that's bad, right? Lekin there are some things jo industry ki territory ke saath aati hain. It's more about that. Jo behind the camera cheeze hoti hain, it's more about that that I want to correct in my life. I have, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, lakh lakh shukr hai. Ke there's so many things that, you know, I could have done wrong. And I've kind of deviated from that. And Alamiya found me the right time, I think. Bilkul right time. But like, ah! It's more like that. So it's not just the acting, you know, it's everything. It's your surrounding. It's who, what's happening around you at that time. So it's all of it together.
I think what was the cause of concern was that you said you're not in it for the longer run. So wo hogi pareshani ke wo longer run ka matlab ye to nahi hai ki acha 6 mahine aur ya Alif jab tak on air hai, agar koi patch work Alif ka reh gaya to wo khatam kara diye.
I mean longer. Nahi main
ye pareshani hogi thi na, us pe bhi clarity thodi si aap de de.
Acha, in short, I'm going to try to find my balance as much as I can. So, main 2-3 saal ke liye to hoon yahan pe aaram se. I'm not saying ki main 40 saal ki umar tak yahi pe rahungi. Main bas ye nahi keh rahi ki main, I'm going to be acting at 40 as well. That's what I'm saying. Ki I'm not going to do this for the rest of my life. And I don't think anybody is, to be really honest. I mean, at the end of the day, hame kahin na kahin apna, you know, ek path aur bhi dhoondna padta hai. So, I'm not doing this till I'm 40. But agle 5 saal tak, I think, agar Allah ne chaha to. But then you never know with me. लेकिन अगर अल्लाह ने चाहा तो I'm here. So don't freak out, guys.
तो उसी बात पे, any future projects that you've signed or in the process of signing that we should know about?
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. I have my signed projects. Actually, I'm inshallah going to be doing another script from Ameraji, which I can't talk about right now, but I will be doing that. And I'm doing the next Nadeem Biggs movie as well. So
that's big news, because nobody knows about that. So you're part of London Nahi Jaunga.
Yes, I am.
So tell us more about London Nahi Jaunga. ओके जसमन, आई आस्क यू कि जेपीएन ने 3 अगर आपको ऑफर होती है आप करेंगे या नहीं? तब आपने नहीं बताया कि आपने तो ऑलरेडी साइन कर लिया लंदन जाओगे।
नहीं, जस्ट आस्क मी कोई और प्रोजेक्ट साइन किया, सो आई थॉट क्या लेट यू नाउ बिकॉज़ जेपीएन ने, आई डोंट नो कब बनेगी, बनेगी या नहीं बनेगी, एंड यू नेवर नो, शायद
मेरे जेपीएन ने कहने का मकसद ये था कि वन ऑफ योर को-स्टार्स हमजा, ऑब्वियसली यू नो फॉर हिम दैट्स द पॉइंट ऑफ रेफरेंस व्हेन ही सेज कि यू नो दीस आर द काइंड ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स दैट आई हैव डन that yeah. I may not want to do in the future.
Yeah.
तो मैं वो समझना चाह रहा था कि आपका thought process भी क्या वही है कि आप इस तरह के, ये मैं कोई बुरा या अच्छा नहीं कह रहा, but these types of projects or these types of projects में से आप ये नहीं करेंगी तो ये करेंगी, ये नहीं करेंगी तो वो करेंगी. Just trying
अच्छा,
to understand.
I think what Hamza, I mean obviously I don't know what his thought process was behind this, लेकिन what I feel is कि JPNA one में when Hamza was there, obviously कुछ scenes थे ऐसे जिस पे Hamza is not proud. So I think that's what he meant, not overall the movie, because I don't think there was anything wrong in JPNA 2. Not because I was a part of it, like mujhe nahi lagta usme aisa
kuch. Even I was a part of JPNA 2.
Exactly, even you were a part of JPNA 2. So exactly, I don't think usme kuch aisa tha. Lekin I think I understand Hamza's point of view. I think wo apni उस कुछ सीन्स के बारे में कह रहे थे, नॉट के ओवरऑल.
मुझे लगा शायद अलिफ का इतना इम्पैक्ट है आप सब लोगों के ऊपर जो उसका पार्ट है कि सारे कोई एक अलग जर्नी पे निकलना चाह रहे हैं. ये
कोई और भी निकल गया,
हमजा निकले हैं ना?
ओह फार फ्रॉम दैट,
हमजा एंड देन यू एंड यू नो, यू नेवर नो, मे बी सज्जल आल्सो से समथिंग और एहसन और मंजर साहब और पिलाज, यंग पिलाज से टुमारो के नाम.
नहीं नहीं नहीं,
यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट लंदन नहीं जाऊंगा.
यस, so london nahi jaunga is the next Nadeem Beg film that I'm doing and I'm very happy about it in fact. Aur usme aisa, I mean the only kind of projects that I don't want to do jo mujhe lage ki I am being, I'm deviating from my principles, principles and morals, that's the kind of things that I don't want to do. And I'm mainly getting a negative role bhi nahi karungi or anything like that. I probably will as long as ki moral hai at the end, as long as there's a reason for it. But yeah, I think I just don't want to do things jisme jo randomly, you know, koi cheez hoti nahi hai, it doesn't have any story, it doesn't have any reason behind it, main wo cheez nahi karungi. And I'm not saying maine aisa kuch kiya in the past, well I have actually, come think of it. Yeah, just I'm going to try to be very careful with what I do next.
I think it makes a lot of sense, yeah. Because every person has sort of their own barometer where they decide ke yaar ke mere liye ye theek hai, mere liye ye theek nahi hai.
Exactly.
And nobody else has any right to say ke nahi ye kyun aur ye kyun nahi.
Thank you.
We support you in your decision. Aap jo karenge hame acha lagega, aap jo nahi karenge wo bhi hame koi masla nahi uske saath.
Thank you. I think bas yehi hai ki I'm going to be careful with what I choose and I'm going to be very selective with the kind of stuff that I choose now. Other than that, I am not quitting again. And
जो परेशानी की बात थी, वो कोई परेशानी की बात.
I am not quitting, but while I'm in working, मैं अपनी एक soul search पे हूँ. And inshallah, I hope कि अल्लाह मियां मुझे और ज़्यादा रास्ते पे डाले.
Inshallah, amen. जाते-जाते आपके fans के लिए कोई message?
I just want to say thank you so much. इन लोगों ने, I mean, मेरी JPNA आई थी, उसके बाद अलिफ आया था. काफ़ी टाइम के लिए आई एम नॉट वर्किंग एज मच एज आप लोग चाहते हैं कि मैं काम करूं, एंड इट्स अ वेरी कॉन्शियस डिसीजन, लेकिन उसके बावजूद आप लोगों ने मुझे इतना ज़्यादा सपोर्ट किया है. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ऑल द लव एंड सपोर्ट. ऑनेस्टली आई डोंट नो व्हाट आई वुड डू विदाउट यू गाइस, बिकॉज़ इफ इट वाज़न्ट फॉर देम आई वुडन्ट बी हियर द फर्स्ट प्लेस, एंड आई थिंक सबको पता है कि हाउ मच आई लव देम, क्योंकि दीज आर द गाइस हू मेक अस राइट. सो थैंक यू सो मच, लॉट्स ऑफ लव एंड दुआ में प्लीज याद रखिएगा, एंड या just wish me luck for my journey and my work both.
I also just want to say that, you know, it's been a pleasure talking to you, and it's so refreshing that, you know, an actor or a star can be so sweet and so down to earth, and you know, it's just amazing the way you are. Oh, and sweet. I wish you well. I hope that whatever your journey is and whatever journey you want to embark on is full of successes,
inshallah,
and happiness, inshallah, and peace.
Inshallah, so, that's the most important
yeah,
thing.
So wish you all the best, and hopefully, inshallah, we'll see you in London. Hi jaunga.
Inshallah, inshallah.
And enjoy it to the fullest.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kubra, for giving us time. Thank
no
you.
No problem. Thank you for having me. Thank you so much.